New government data showing a troubling rise in hate and bias crimes in Oregon. Last year, we followed the case of a pair of Tigard men who pleaded guilty to assaulting their black neighbor, a crime that police say was racially motivated. This is Coin 6 News at 6 o'clock. I'm Jenny Hansen in for Jeff.
And I'm Elizabeth Den. So now the prosecutor who pursued that bias case has created a specialized team to combat hate. Joelle Jones is going to be on the headlines tonight to explain.
Washington County District Attorney Kevin Barton says this team is the first of its kind here in Oregon, and one that has certainly captured the attention of the federal government, as they've already been awarded $600,000 just within the past 2 years. With that money, Barton says his office will continue to protect victims and hold perpetrators accountable. This shocking video obtained by Coin 6 News shows family members Raymond Hanners and Damian Shirk attack their neighbor outside a Tigard apartment complex in October of last year. The Washington County Sheriff's Office says Hanners used racial slurs while provoking his African-American neighbor to approach him before he and Shirk assaulted the man, who was left with multiple injuries.
The underlying issue was an assault that happened in a neighborhood environment, and at least a portion of that was racially motivated.
Last week, both Hanners and Shirk pleaded guilty to assault, with Hanners also pleading guilty to bias crime. The sheriff's office says both men were sentenced to 3 years of supervised probation in order to attend anger evaluations.
What's the deterrent if that's being held accountable?
Well, I agree. In fact, that's the first response I had when I saw this. And, you know, we want to do as much as we can to respond in an appropriate level when a crime occurs. And at the end of the day, the DA's office, we can't control ultimately every single sentence that happens. And in this particular case, we actually advocated for a higher sentence.
Well, in this case, a judge determined sentencing. Washington County District Attorney Kevin Barton tells us his team is committed to holding those who commit bias crimes accountable while providing supervision and educational classes to potentially change their mindset. His office launched the state's first bias crime multidisciplinary team, which accepted $300,000 in funding from the federal government this week, in addition to the previous $300,000 grant received in 2021, which Barton says will help his office continue their work to reduce incidents of hate and bias.
When bias crimes happen, big or small, it's important that we respond to those crimes to ensure that the perpetrator is held accountable and responsible for that, but also that the victim of that crime and victims of future crimes know that when something happens, there will be a response and justice will follow.
This comes as FBI data shows the number of bias incidents and victims reported in Oregon have only grown over the last 4 years. Since developing the team and increasing community outreach, Barton says his office has seen a major spike in incidents being reported, cases being referred and prosecuted, telling us they now file charges in 9 out of every 10 cases received. Now, with both state and federal data suggesting bias crimes are widely underreported, Barton says with this additional money, his team plans to hire an outreach coordinator to enhance public engagement, education, and to help victims report these crimes. Now, if you or someone you know believes you've been a victim of a bias crime, we have linked out resources for you at coin.com. Reporting in Washington County tonight, I'm Joelle Jones, Coin 6 News.